Breaking: Clinton plot to take down Eric Bolling revealed, please pray. In a situation that has become unusually common for Fox News personalities, Yash Raleigh of the Huffington Post reported that Eric Bolling, Fox News personality, sent lewd text messages to numerous female co-workers, resulting in his suspension. Interestingly enough, the law firm who is investigating the matter, Paul, Weiss, Rifkind, Wharton and Garrison LLP, has long-standing ties with the Clinton family. Employees of the firm raised hundreds of thousands in campaign funds for Hillary Clinton and Obama officials, and later cashed in on political appointments in government. Jesse Johnson, former Obama staffer who stepped down as Secretary of Homeland Security, is rejoining the firm where he formerly worked, according to the Washington Free Beacon. One fundraiser the law firm ran, which was billed as a conversation with Hillary, was promoted on her website at a cost of $2,700 per ticket. This isn't the first time this law firm has come under public scrutiny. 2 years ago, the firm caused a serious breach of security at the Guantanamo Bay prison by sending anti-American literature in Arabic to detainees that encouraged prisoners to claim they were being tortured. Even worse, the firm's lawyers have played key roles in working to secure the release of inmates accused of committing acts of terrorism. Al Jowdy and Yousef Al-Sheri were just two of many that the lawyers helped release. Al-Sheri later continued his terrorist activities and was eventually killed in a firefight. The Clintons and this law firm have a history that goes hand in hand. Jeh Johnson, the former Secretary of Homeland Security, is returning to the firm where he formerly worked, and will become a partner in the firm's litigation department. Some wonder if it's concerning that the former Secretary of Homeland Security is working for a law firm that has an extensive history of freeing Guantanamo Bay terrorists, something that clearly isn't aiding Homeland Security. Regardless, Johnson doesn't feel that is the case and is rather excited to be bringing his public service experience back to the firm. Other connections between the Clintons and the law firm include Todd Stern, former firm employee, who was appointed as Clinton's special envoy for climate change. Paul Bender and Melissa Prober, also former employees, currently work as counselors at the Clinton Foundation. With such deep ties to the Clintons, it would not be surprising if the law firm's decision to investigate this case against Bolling is more politically motivated than it first appears. Nor is this the first case in which a Fox News anchor has been kicked off the channel for allegations of sexual misconduct. Bill O'Reilly's departure from Fox News a few months earlier started a dangerous precedent where a rogue accusation is sufficient enough to jeopardize a career. Regardless of whether Bolling is guilty or not, this entire fiasco is being handled right through the liberal, progressive playbook, silencing opposition voices through the use of accusation, slander, and scandal, proven or not. Americans need to be aware of how far the puppet strings of the Clinton family extend. The hidden connections between the Clintons and this law firm need to be exposed.